Yo, what's going on, guys? KrispyFlakes here. So the New Orleans Pelicans just swept the Portland Trailblazers 4-0 in the 2018 NBA playoffs, round one. So I went on my Twitter account and I posted a poll saying, should Damian Lillard be traded? And actually the majority of people said that he should be traded from the Portland Trailblazers. And I'm actually going to go against the popular opinion and say no way he should be traded. Yes, he had a very bad series. He got exposed by Jrue Holiday, but Damian Lillard is 27. Damian Lillard, for the most part, is one of the best point guards in the NBA. And like I said, guys, he's 27. He is literally just entering his NBA prime. And I feel like, you know, based off that one series to just completely blow things up does not make sense. Now, with that being said, do I think that maybe we should rebuild around Damian Lillard in a different way? I could totally agree with that. I mean, CJ McCollum is a great NBA player. He's got some trade value out there. I feel like, you know, splitting him up with Damian Lillard might be the right move. Maybe go for a better center or small forward or something along those lines. We do have Nurkic on this team still. He's only 23. Now, I think he's a restricted free agent. He's a player that I definitely want to bring back to this team. Now, would I involve him in a sign and trade? Potentially, maybe to bring a better player alongside Damian Lillard. I can see myself doing that. Yeah, so a lot of different options on this team. It's just, I'm not personally feeling a trade of Damian Lillard just because a player like that does not come around often to an NBA franchise. I think a lot of it's overreaction, disappointment, you know, in Portland Trailblazer fans and Damian Lillard fans in general. So yeah, man, we're going to go through this, ready to do a three-season rebuild. Ed Davis, he's not an expiring deal, so depending on what he wants back, he'd be a nice backup center on this team still. Shabazz Napier had one of his better NBA seasons at the age of 26. Really good shooter, really good offensive player off the bench. Realistically, like, if we needed to, we could make him a shooting guard, kind of like a Lou Williams type of thing out there. Alfred Aminu, 76 overall, still has only a one-year $7 million contract. Bitch has Evan Turner contract right here, guys. I don't know what to do about this. I do not want to know what to do about Evan Turner. It's like, to get rid of him, you'd probably have to toss in a first or second round draft pick at this point. It's only got a two-year deal now, so maybe a second rounder could get it done. Maurice Harkless, decent NBA player, but also a bitch ass contract. Myers Leonard, I mean, this dude does nothing out there except literally be garbage. Zach Collins, this is a player I definitely want to invest in for this three-season rebuild. Next season, he might spend most of it in the G League to help develop him even farther. Yeah, so let's get started on this. As far as, like, any trades, I might hold off until after the NBA's draft just to kind of see, like, you know, maybe we could trade, like, a CJ McCollum for a top pick in the draft or something along those lines. I know one player I'm definitely interested in is, like, a Hassan Whiteside, just because I feel like him alongside Damian Lillard, both those guys had horrible postseasons, but both might, you know, want to, like, use that as motivation going forward. I just feel like it would be a nice change of pace for Hassan Whiteside to go to a team like the Portland Trailblazers. So let's look at a trade for CJ McCollum. We'll toss him the first round draft pick. It's 26 overall, so nothing too crazy right there. See what is offered up to our team. So Dario Saric, Robert Covington, we got Chris Middleton, pretty much, you know, both, you know, 85 overall players. Bobby Portis would be pretty solid for a rebuild. Ronnie Hood, we got Al Horford, decent. DeAndre Jordan, that's actually not too bad right there. He is 29 though. We got Mike Conley, Taurean Prince, Kent Bazemore. Okay, so I was talking about Hassan Whiteside. So we get Whiteside, we do have to give away first and second round draft pick. We also get Justice Winslow, who has not been all that great for the Miami Heat. I mean, he has his moments and everything, but this trade is actually really nice because it finally gives us that rebuilding small forward this team needs. Only 22, but we also get the veteran player back in Hassan Whiteside right here. While the Miami Heat, they get a big time go-to scoring CJ McCollum to be in the backcourt with Dragic, and they get some nice draft picks out of it. So I'm kind of feeling that one the most so far. Jimmy Lamb, Dwight Howard, Rudy Gobert, Joe Ingles, Buddy Hield. Okay, so we're going to go through the rest of the trades here. I think I'm really feeling that Hassan Whiteside trade, though, guys. It's pretty nice. Blake Griffin would definitely be decent. I know personally, as a Pistons fan, I would do this trade in a heartbeat just because my Pistons, you know, we already got Andre Drummond. You get CJ McCollum, really good shooting guard, big time scorer out there. Damn, that's actually a really nice trade, too. I don't know which one I like more, because Blake Griffin, because then we can also re-sign back Nurkic. Because, like, if we do the trade of Hassan Whiteside, it's like, what do we do with Nurkic? I think we could probably do a sign trade with him. But also the fact, see, this trade right here, though, we also get Justice Winslow back, and which is just kind of offsets, you know, getting Blake Griffin. So I think this is probably the better deal for us just because it helps us go in the direction of either a rebuild but also a win now mode. Guys, I'm gonna do this trade, get Hassan Whiteside and Justice Winslow on this team. And I feel like Hassan Whiteside did not do much with the Miami Heat. So I think Miami Heat fans would be happy getting a guy like CJ McCollum to go along on their squad right there. It definitely feels realistic to me. With that being said, though, we're not gonna do the NBA draft. I think I traded away all my draft picks, so not gonna worry about that. Let's go to staff signing, though, just because Terry Stotts, I believe, is the coach of this team. And rating wise, he's okay, I guess. He's okay, but nothing really to call home about. So I think I am going to go in a different direction and fire him here. I might just offer up the boy Michael Stafford just because he always, you know, has good coaching stats and everything. So we'll give him a nice little contract, see if he'll sign up to that. He's still thinking about it. Come on, man. And he's accepted. All right, sign this dude up. We'll say he's Coach KrispyFlakes or something like that. Okay, NBA draft. I was going to skip that for this first season right here because we don't have a good draft pick. So, okay, rookie signings. Yeah, nothing at all. Team player options. Jake Lehman. Yeah, I'm going to decline him. Qualifying offers. We got Nurkic. If he signs that qualifying offer, dude, I would definitely do a sign trade with him. I guess I could put him at power forward. It's just like, feels like a waste of a good young center. It's like, if there's no really good trades offered up, I might honestly keep him and just use him at my bench for now until Sam Whiteside gets old and retired or something like that. I don't know. As far as free agents go, do I see any of these players really come to this team? For the most part, not really. JJ Redick alongside, Damian Lillard would actually be really nice. Just a catch and shoot player. Avery Bradley. We do have all those bitch ass contracts. So, damn, it's like, do I want to toss in the first round draft picks and try to get rid of some of these guys? I feel like at this point it might make sense too. So I'm going to toss in, Evan Turner with the first round draft pick. If it's going to let me, because 2K, I don't know what it does sometimes. Come on, 2K. I'm trying to do the draft pick here, man. I don't want to. Okay, one second, guys. It's making me trade my former players again. One sec. Okay, so this is the best trade I can find. Evan Turner goes to the 76ers. They also get that first round draft pick. In return, we get Furkan something and Justin Anderson, I guess. So, yeah, we'll do that trade, I suppose. Saves us money in the long run of things. I hate losing the first round draft pick, but sometimes that's what you gotta do to get rid of the bitch-ass contracts. I'm also gonna try to do the same thing here with Myers Leonard, just to kind of save that money if it lets us. And one second, guys, 2K is really screwing up today. Okay, so this trade right here, we get Ike Anibogu back, who is a 75 overall power forward. We also have to give the better draft pick to the Indiana Pacers in the 2021st NBA draft. I'm okay with that. Just get Myers Leonard off my team, and hopefully that does free up a bit more money now. I am going to go to Renounce Rights, wherever that, cap holds, my bad, and go through these real quick here. But I guess like a lot of these guys, yeah, we'll just do this. I still don't know if I have enough money to like sign any of those other guys out there, which is not really that big a deal. I might just go for like a low player at the shooting guard position. But yeah, I was looking at JJ Redick. Okay, we can give him a 2-year, $12 million deal. I'm gonna try to offer him a little bit more just to kind of like, get him on the team here. So JJ Redick, we'll give him that. Any other players we could offer up that type of money to? Dwayne Wade, I don't really want him. Mark Bellinelli, decent. Yo, Will Barton. Will Barton would actually be a nice fit. He's only 27, good score. So kind of like that trade, or that deal, I should say. KCP, bit too expensive for my liking. Avery Bradley would be nice. Once again, too expensive, so we're not gonna be able to get him. Zach LaVine. Okay, that's about all we got right here. So Will Barton, we could get him on the squad, I think, since he's gonna take us over. So might have to renounce some rights here. Ed Davis, renounce those rights. Okay, do I want to renounce on Shabazz? I really don't think I want to. I think I'd rather have, I don't know, man. Who'd I rather have at this point? Shabazz is 77 overall, man. So I think I'm gonna decline that. And JJ Redick going to the San Antonio Spurs. I'm fine with that. I really did not want to do that trade all that much. Sometimes you gotta like say no. Just kind of like a negotiation tactic, I guess. Fred Van Vliet. He's actually a pretty cheap player. 24 years of age. So we'll sign him up if he wants to come on the squad. I'm gonna see if I can. Okay, let me try Will Barton again, I guess. Because if I get Van Vliet, no, I'm not gonna be able to get both those guys. Fred Van Vliet, I'll definitely take him. Got matched by him. And Will Barton also going to the San Antonio Spurs. So I guess everybody in existence is going to the Spurs. I guess let's make sure we get Shabazz back. I'm gonna give him a 2-year deal. I'm gonna give him some pretty good money because that's actually a really low amount of salary for what he can bring to this team. I might actually low-key end up being my starting shooting guard though, guys, just because I don't know if I have a lot of other options there. Avery Bradley still available. Wayne Ellington. Seth Curry. Seth Curry's pretty cheap. Only 27. I'm gonna give him a nice little contract. And come on, Seth. All right, we got Seth Curry. Okay, he'll be a good starting shooting guard for us. Just a catch and shoot type of player. So besides for that, guys, I think I'm pretty much good to go. I'm gonna make sure we get Nurkic back on this team, and then I'm going to simulate to the beginning of the regular season. Okay, so I am thinking I'm going to try to trade away Maurice Harkless just so I can free up some more cap space. We really don't need him anymore now that we have Justin Wendell on this team. So I'm gonna toss in a future first round draft pick also with him, guys. Our draft pick game is just gonna be so lacking here, but it is what it is. So let's see what we can get here, man. We got, come on, man. I literally just want like as cheap as I can get. Come on, 2K. Please, man, please. Just give me, like, a $2 million contract. That's all I need in life. Kyle Korver, Zizic. We got to give him 2 first-round draft picks to do this. I mean, Kyle Korver would be nice off our bench and honestly could start at shooting guard. Zizic is a good young center. I don't want to give up 2 first-round draft picks, though. But if it means getting rid of Maurice Harkless and his contract, I guess I will do it. I don't think it frees up a ton of money for us. But like the main reason I'm trying to do this, guys, is because I'm trying to get Daniel Theis on this team to be our starting power forward for this NBA season. I still can't afford him, though, so we might just get screwed there. It is what it is, guys. Let's simulate to the beginning of the regular season. Okay, so I'm kind of stupid. All I had to do was just sign him to less money. So, okay, so we do have Daniel Theis on this team finally. Just because he's like 6'9", can shoot the 3 ball, and I feel like while, you know, Zach Collins is in the G League, a guy like Daniel Theis might still be pretty good on this team. Okay, so this is what the team looks like going into this first season. We got Damian Lillard, Seth Curry, Justice Winslow, Daniel Theis, and Hassan Whiteside. Nurkic for now, guys. I'm going to use him off the bench. I'm going to see how he rolls right there. I mean, he's only 23, so it's not like he's going to like kill his career or anything like that. We got Aminu at small forward, Shabazz at point guard. I'm going to run Kyle Korver at the shooting guard position. And then real quick here, I am going to go put Zach Collins in the G League so we can hopefully develop nicely right there. So let's go ahead and do that. Zach Collins assigned to G League. Without further ado, guys, let's go ahead and simulate this season, see how this team does. Hopefully we are better than last year and don't get swept in the first round of the playoffs. Okay, so a record of 56-25, which is good for, once again, third place in the Western Conference. As we all know, though, it's going to come down to the playoffs and really stepping up there. But by the look of things, the regular season went pretty nicely right here. So here's all the awards for you guys to see. Let's see if Damian Lillard made any of these teams right here. He did not, from what I'm seeing right here. Okay. Well, let's check out these player stats now. We got. Dame Lillard at 21 points, 7 assists. Hassan Whiteside, a very nice season, guys. 17 points, 12 rebounds, over 2 blocks per game. Definitely felt resurrected this NBA season. Seth Curry, very nicely at the shooting guard position. Nurkic off the bench. Great to, numbers. It's like maybe found a home right there. Justice Winslow, you know, not a big-time scorer, but definitely good at defense. I know he brought that to the team. Daniel Theis, kind of some bitch-ass numbers, but it's all good. Shabazz did pretty decent right here. And Zach Collins is now a 79 overall player. So he'll probably be our starting power forward for this NBA playoff run right here. So let's go to this. And okay, I guess, okay, I'm fine with using Nurkic there for now. I'm sorry, Daniel Theis. But no, I am going to switch out Hassan Whiteside with Nurkic. Take away his minutes. Give a few more to Justice Winslow. I want Damian Lillard playing a lot in the playoffs right here. Just because like he's that type of player. Shooting guard, they actually got Kyle Korver playing right there. We're going to switch him out with Seth Curry real quick. Just because, I don't know, it feels like the better move. Theis, Hassan Whiteside. Okay, guys, I think we're pretty much good to go for the playoffs. This team, I think, can definitely make a nice run. So let's go ahead and simulate this first series. We do have the San Antonio Spurs, Kawhi Leonard, simulate current round. And come on, man. Okay, so just like that, guys, we do win the first round of the playoffs, 4-1. Closeout game 22-6 for Damian Lillard. We got 21-11 for Hassan Whiteside. Very nice. Second round, we have the Houston Rockets. I don't know if we're going to get past them. Simulate current round. And okay, we do not get past them, guys. 4-2. Kind of disappointing right there. But I mean, at the same time, the Houston Rockets are just one of those type of teams out there. So it's like, what can you do about that? Similar to the rest of the playoffs, we are going to go into this second season. Not a ton of moves to be made, in my own opinion here. I mean, it's like, I guess I'm going to try to get Nurkic back. I'm going to skip the NBA draft, though, just because like we don't have a lot of draft picks anyway. So go straight to that. And what do we get, man? We get PJ George Washington. I do not want you on my team. Team player options. Hassan Whiteside declined his player option. Okay, so now it comes down to the mindset if we really want to go for a guy like Hassan Whiteside, who is going to be 30. He's going to want a bitch-ass contract. Or if we just try to get the boy Nurkic back, who had a really good NBA season for us. We are going to extend both of these right here. Moratorium period. Okay, so we got LeBron James, Hassan Whiteside. Not a lot of other great players that I want here. It's like the shooting guard position, I'm pretty much good with that. Of course, everybody wants LeBron James. I don't see him ever going to this team, though. I think I might just try to get Whiteside back. It's a bitch-ass contract, though, guys. It really is a bitch-ass contract. So that's all right, though. It's like there's not really any other players I want to get. So we're going to sign back here. Also, Nurkic, go for him. That's a lot of money tied up between these two players, but hey, man, it is what it is. I think it's not Whiteside. Like, we could trade him if we wanted to later on anyway, and Justice Winslow will give him the money here too. I think he deserves it. All right, so that's like all of our salary kept eating up just like that. Whatever, bro. All right, what else we got here? we want to go for Reggie Bullock. I always like Reggie Bullock. I don't know why. I always think he's a really solid player. So, point guard, shooting guard. Probably he's a good backup shooting guard. Wesley Matthews. Get him back on the Portland Trailblazers like he was once upon a time. We got Reggie Bullock. Wesley Matthews going to the Phoenix Suns. Center position, we're probably good with that. Like I was saying, not a ton of moves to be made in this NBA offseason. Just re-signing back our core for the most part. So let's go ahead, guys, and simulate to the beginning of the regular season. Okay, so this is what the lineup looks like going into the second season. Dame Lillard and Seth Curry still in the backcourt. Justin Winslow now at 82 overall. Zach Collins, 79 overall. We got Hassan Whiteside, 88. And we still got Nurkic on the team with Daniel Tice, Shabazz, and Reggie Bullock to round out our nine-man rotation. Everybody progressed very nicely. I think this team definitely can contend now in the Western Conference. I think we could at least make it to the Western Conference Finals. Are we an NBA championship team? That depends how nicely Zach Collins plays this season. But for the most part, I don't know, man. I think this team, I think we rebuilt it very nicely here. So let's simulate this second season and see how far we can get in the NBA playoffs, or if we can at least make the NBA playoffs. Okay, so a very close Western Conference race, a record of 58-23, one more game left in the season. We could potentially move up to first place, or at least tie for first with the Houston Rockets, simulate through date. And we finish with a W on the season, guys. We get first place in the Western Conference. Once again, though, it means nothing because regular season, so we definitely got to make some noise here in the playoffs to see what we can do out there. Here's the All-NBA teams for you guys to see here. And, yeah, guys, let's go ahead and check out these player stats before we get into these playoffs. Playoff stats, we got Dame Lillard at about 25 points, 3 rebounds, 7 assists. Hassan Whiteside, once again, a great NBA season for him, 16 points, 10 rebounds. If you are a Trailblazers fan, would you like to see Hassan Whiteside on your NBA team? We got Seth Curry at about 14 points, 5 assists. Nurkic, another really good NBA season, regardless that he is on the bench. Justice Winslow, solid numbers. Zach Collins, first year as a starter, about 10 points and 6 rebounds per game with 3 assists. And then that's the rest of the bench units. All right, first round, Sacramento Kings. Not really afraid of them. Here we go. Simulate current round. And, oh my God, please don't lose. No. Oh my God, guys, they just blew a 3-1 lead, man. Oh my God, okay, we almost just lost in the first round of the playoffs to the Sacramento Kings. I would have been so pissed off at that. Damn, dude. Okay, so Seth Curry, 19 points. The unsung hero of the game 7. Dame Lillard, 15-7. 14-6 for Zach Collins. Next up, the Golden State Warriors. Not feeling too good for that last series. Simulate current round. And once again, guys, we lose 4-1. I don't know, man. I don't know. I know I said this was going to be a 3-season rebuild, but I mean, like, this video is getting kind of long on me here. So I think I am going to end it right here, guys. I don't know what to do, man. It's like, my mindset, well, last night when they lost to the Pelicans was, okay, maybe they should trade Damian Lillard. And then I was like, you know what, I'm going to do a rebuild. I'm going to try to treat the man with respect and keep him on the team. But at the end of the day, it's like the Portland Trailblazers, they are stuck in a very, very tough conference with a really good point guard, though. Maybe it is time to just rebuild. I don't know, guys. Let me know what you all think in the comment section below. And peace out, my friends.